So based on this beautiful relation on the duality of particles, of particles and waves of light, we wanted to talk about something that we can all relate, for example, visible light, and that's why we have UV visible spectroscopy. It's when we have absorption of radiation in the UV visible energy, and what this is going to do is going to excite electrons from the ground states and to the excited states, to the higher energy. And this change in energy, this gain in energy, is going to be quantized related to the Einstein-Planck-Einstein relation. In the atoms, it's a jump between the background state and the excited states. In molecules, we have electrons that are excited from the highly occupied molecular orbital to the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. So, of course, again, when the energy levels are quantized, the change in energy is quantized too. UV visible spectroscopy is particularly useful for conjugated systems in organic molecules. The easiest conjugated systems that came up, it's a Benson ring, and it is a combination of single and double bonds, as we can soon see here. However, Benson is not a colorful compound. It has absorption in the 200 nanometer range, so it really doesn't show any particular color. If we want absorption of visible spectra, we need to have larger conjugated systems, as it is the case of beta-carotene. We have a larger molecule with, again, a combination of single and double bonds, chemical double bonds. And this absorbs into the 400 nanometer range and 500 nanometer range, which would tell us it has an absorption in the blue. If we see absorption in the blue, the color that is going to reflect is the opposite color. So according to our color wheel here, if absorbance substance absorbs here in the blue, it's going to appear orange. And that is why carrots are orange. That is the pigment that makes color to carrots. So here we have absorbance spectra with three different compounds. We have chlorophyll A, which is quite normal in all plants, and chlorophyll B, and also we have carotenoids. So the chlorophyll A has absorption in the 400 nanometer range, as well as in the 700 nanometer range, and that's why this Y appears green, because this it looks the opposite wavelength that is absorbing, as well as chlorophyll B that has an absorption in the below the 500 nanometers. So the application of this, when we're going to measure again this spectra, is the UV spectrometer. We have the source, prism, that monochromator that's going to separate light in the specific wavelengths, and a beam splitter that's going to make this light go into reference cells and a sample cell. And what they measure is the intensity of light of the reference cell related to the sample cell. The ratio of these two is the absorbance of the material. And if we have the absorbance spectrum, we have a measure of the concentration of a specific compound in a sample. So if we take our carrots along with the leaves and put it in a blender, we're mixing beta-carotene and chlorophyll. And if we do the UV spectrometer, right, we can actually determine the concentration of each of our two compounds. That is pretty much.
So all right, so now we're going to do